What you want to put on again? some sort of theater play? Ball, ball, ball. All it is ball play to me. By the time it's over, I wish I'd gone to college, got myself a better job. Oh, this is how she wanted it. She wants to move, she can get some athlete or somebody to do it. One more thing. The lights? I think these lights are plenty fine. Fluorescents, like I had in my day. What are they? Miss it? No. Found it. Now I've done it. What I've done.
Janet, relax. We're always just on time. How are you, Mr. Peterson? Nothing cooking yet?
So, you're the Catherine Hepburn this year. I bet you think you're going straight from Riverview High School play to Broadway to Hollywood.
Not me. Television.
Yeah. Well, all I gotta say is I've been watching plays when I'm here for years and years. And every year somebody gets it into her head that she's the new Gloria Swanson. Look out! It ain't you! Oh, I'm an actress. I'm so great.
Good old Tony. Wonder what turned him against the world.
Some unhappy love affair, probably.
I vote sour stomach. Hey! Hey! No echo? What a bar! Sour stomach!
Elsie, I'm so excited, I can't sit still. Aren't you thrilled to get a role in the fall play?
Well, you know what role, don't you? Probably the maid.
Yes, madam. No, madam. May I shine your shoes, madam?
You won't know what role you get until Miss Burgess gets here. What's keeping everybody? I'm ready to burst.
Well, don't stand so close to me, kid. I've got a hot Friday night date.
This is Friday, isn't it?
Fuck O'Hara, don't tell me you have a part in this play.
Yeah? Yeah, what's the matter with that?
Nothing? Why, at least I think it's marvelous. I'm a great admirer of yours, Buck. Baseball, basketball, football! I mean, it's right there screaming!
I give up. What play could we be doing where there's a role for this Neanderthal character?
What? What'd you call me? I didn't come here if people make fun of me.
Oh, perish the thought, Buck. I think you're a lovely hunk of man.
Me too. I mean,
of course, I don't claim to be an actor or anything.
Well, neither does Brad Pitt.
Buck, do you have any idea what the fall play is about? From the little parts they had me read at tryouts, I couldn't make any sense out of it.
Something about the Civil War, I think. But I'm not going to be in if I throw a burnt cork all over my face.
Oh, you won't, Buck. You'll be Brett Butler, and I'll be Scarlett O'Hara.
There's no doubt we'll play the lead roles. Either one of them.
You have it straight from the horse's mouth, of course.
Well, Jacko Guthrie has all the experience. Civic theater and everything. He even has it on Broadway.
Uh-huh.
And who could be better than Nancy Leverage for the heroine?
Nancy Leverage? Nancy Leverage, is there anything in this school she isn't?
That's just pure, silly, ugly jealousy speaking.
Well, excuse me. I forgot Nancy was poor little Janet's play goddess.
Well, Elsie, are you talking about me?
Oh.
Hello, Nancy.
As a matter of fact, I was.
Wouldn't you like to say it to my face?
With pleasure. I was just putting into words what about 90% of the senior class feels. That it's not fair for you to soak up every honor and sight, including the lead, in this fall's production.
And I said she was envious.
And no leads! I didn't come here to be the middle of the headlight.
I don't have the leading role yet, Elsie.
But you will, Nancy.
Don't count on it too hard. Loretta Fuller's coming, and I'm to understand she gave a very fine reading at tryouts.
Who told you that?
Why,
The very same boy who's taking you to the homecoming dance. Jocko Guthrie himself.
I don't believe it. Nor do I.
Look out! I'm on the
do you any good?
Well, so far all it's attracted is one jackass with a bow tie.
Do that again, Janet! What part are you going to play? Off-feed horse with a cold in the head?
You are the most insulting boy I have ever!
Don't pay any attention to me. I don't know what gets into me. I drive people crazy. All kinds of people, especially my father. He doesn't know what gets into him. Nor do I. Can't say I blame him, though. I swear that guy is almost ready for a psychiatrist.
I pity Miss Burgess. Imagine having to direct Milt Sanders in the first play you ever put on in high school.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about Miss Burgess. I'm just putty in the hands of a pretty teacher. We're gonna hit it off like crazy.
It will be a welcome change when Milton Sanders hits it off with any teacher.
Women don't understand me.
Men don't understand you either, Milt.
Ah, but it's the women I worry about, Buck. To be or not to be, that is the question. Well, well, well. If it isn't God's gift to the women of this high school, Gregory Peck, I presume, who let you in, Sanders?
Hello, Janet. Glad to see you have a role in the play.
Yes, Janet. We're very glad to see you have a role.
And Elsie, I'm sure we will enjoy working together.
Oh, yeah. We're going to have one wild time working together. Taw-taw, tee-tee, ho-ho, and all that rigmarole.
Ew! Oh,
sorry I missed lunch, Nancy.
Just too busy at lunch, you know, Nancy, old gal. Had to have a conference with Noel Coward and Bill Shakespeare. They're writing a play together, you know. It's gonna star me.
Nobody else here yet.
Oh, don't worry, Jocko. You have the lead. But Ned.
I prefer a juicy character role myself. Lori not here yet.
What do you mean, not here yet?
Well, she's coming, Nancy. After the reading she gave at tryouts, she's in for a big part. That's all I know.
A good sight reading can often fool people. You said that yourself.
Me out!
Why won't anybody come? Can anyone ever be on time? The fact is, Jocko, I'm surprised you're here this early. You never seem this prompt on dates. On dates with me, that is.
Oh, oh. Little Nancy's on her high horse today, isn't she?
Prima donna stuff already, Nancy?
Seriously? Oh, quiet down, Nancy. Nobody's late. We're just early.
What a lie. Here she comes! We've just been talking about you, Lori, and you should have heard. You should have heard it too, Andy. You see, Nancy here thinks Lori's in for the leading part. And you know what? Nancy also
That is not the truth at all, Milt. Don't pay any attention to Milt. He's already admitted that he's off his beam.
Hello, everybody.
Hi, Lori.
I never pay any attention to Milt anyways, do I, Milt? Jumbo must be wrong, Nancy. What chance do I have? I've never even been on stage before.
That's what she keeps saying, but it's not the way she keeps acting. Do you think this play is more important than anything else her senior year?
Hi, Elsie. Hi. Janet, how are you today?
More important than your journalism scholarship, Lori? Andy's acting very odd. Don't listen to him.
Of course the play is not as important as the scholarship.
Yeah, but she has that sewn up. Now she's got this stage bug. Ever since tryouts, it's been like dating a total stranger. She's in another world.
Personally, I thought you'd be too busy editing the yearbook to spend any time with football production. Rehearsals do take up a lot of time.
I can juggle my time around if I do really get a part.
Yeah, you can juggle your time around, and you know how much is going to be left for me, don't you?
We'll manage, Andy. We always have. Don't keep feeling sorry for yourself. You're begging for trouble.
Begging? I'm not begging. I just want things to be the way they've always been.
Jealousy is the basis of human emotions.
You stick your nose out.
If I ever saw a guy green with jealousy.
Good morning, you Milt.
You know, in the part of the play I read, there was a love scene. A honey of a love scene. Between the leading man and the leading woman. Now, if Jocko here should be the if Nancy here should be the leading girl, who's going to be the leading man?
Jocko!
Not Andy!
All that has nothing to do with it.
Surely no one can be that naive. Kissing a girl on stage means nothing. This is the theater.
I don't care what it is, Jocko. You try kissing Lori, and I'll throw you from here all the way to the box office.
So that is it, Andy! You are jealous! That's what's been eating you ever since tryout! You pretend like you're worried about me! How I was gonna split up my time! Whether I let the stage bug bite me! Whether I lose interest in journalism or not! All that! What it comes down to is, you're jealous!
Jealous of what? Why does everyone just keep assuming that Lori's gonna have the lead?
Why do you think I tried out for this? You think I want to be any darn fool play? Put a lot of goo on your face, strut around on stage, make noises and work like an idiot. Learn lines and rehearse, say the same thing 20,000 times until you get it right. The only reason I'm here is because you had to take a chance at it. Any sensible person be out there playing ball or tennis or walking or loafing under a tree. You're not walking up and down in here pretending to be someone he isn't and never could be and wouldn't want to be if he could.
You don't have to do that.
Andy! Andy, is this a rebellion in our ranks even before we start? If this is the way you honestly feel, then perhaps you better relinquish the role I had planned to assign you. I'm sure there are many other students who would like to have it.
Golly, no, Miss Burgess. I want to be in the play, honest.
Oh, he sure does, Miss Burgess, and we know why.
His reasons are not important. Now that you're all seated, we'll begin. For the first few days, this will be my table. Now, before I begin, and before I sign any of the roles, there are a few remarks I'd like to make. Now, is everyone here?
Yes, well, that looks like it.
Yeah.
Hey!
Who's that?
Wait for us! We're here!
It's not 3:30 yet! Here we are!
Sorry! We ran all the way.
It's just 3:30.
Did you start yet? You're not late, girls. It's exactly 3:30 now. May I begin again?
Yes. Proceed.
On at least one point, you will find that I'm a mean old stick of a teacher in the worst sense. I demand promptness, not only because tardiness annoys me personally, but because it is unfair to the other members of your cast.
Consideration for your teammates is one of the many, many rather pleasant lessons I hope that all of us will learn. All of us, I should say, because the production of a play is like playing a game. Buck and Andy, you're on the baseball team. You should know what I'm talking about. Although spectacular catches may be important to the game, they might not win the season. What wins the game is the way that you 10 boys work together.
10 is Burgess?
I beg your pardon, Buck?
There's only 9 boys on a baseball team.
Oh, yes, of course. Thank you, Buck. I always get confused. I must have been thinking of football. Now, as I was saying, every role is important, even the smallest. If we can remember that, then we'll enjoy the production and take from it important human values. Now, are there any questions? Nancy?
Miss Burgess, are you saying that it doesn't matter if we have a leading role or some insignificant part?
No, Nancy, I'm not saying that it doesn't matter. I'm saying that even the smallest role, we can learn and have as much fun. Do you disagree with that?
Well, not exactly, but my father would.
Of course.
Well, Nancy, one of these days, I'd like to be able to speak with your father.
Good luck.
Any further questions?
How long before we pull off this circus?
4 weeks from tonight is the production.
Miss Burgess, I don't think I can be in the play. Lori and I have a journalism conference on the 28th at State University. Lori has to give a speech, and that's the university we're going to in the fall. So, guess we might as well ramble along.
But Andy, we don't even know what parts we have yet.
Does it matter now?
Yes! Too bad, Lori. Just a moment, everybody. 4 weeks from tonight is the 21st, not the 28th.
Oh, 31st, 7th, 14th, 21st. I can't win.
Now that we have that settled, I'll have to make a confession myself. I forgot the playbooks on my desk in room 8207. Once I'm done reading your rules, you may go pick them up yourselves. I won't tell you much about the play itself, because I want you to enjoy reading it. The play is a romantic drama that takes place in the Deep South in the garden of an old plantation. Now, let me see here. Andrew Fulbright. You will be the father to the heroine, the plantation owner, Mr. Charles Marquis.
Me, a father?
Jocko Guthrie. You will be playing the handsome young hero, Randolph, a southern aristocrat.
Of course.
Milton Sanders. You will be playing Luke, the family retainer.
Me.
Yes, you.
In blackface.
In my face.
Well, hush my mouth.
At this point, I'd also like to say that I didn't get to select this play. That was done by the play selection committee, headed by the senior sponsor.
Oh, we've already forgiven you, Miss Burgess.
Yeah. Now, Buck.
Here we go.
I have a very juicy role for you. Your name will be Owen Hamilton, a rich and ruthless exporter from Savannah.
Are you sure, Miss Burgess?
Yes, Buck, I'm sure. With a few rehearsals, I'm sure you'll make a very powerful character.
Gosh, what's the team gonna say?
Now, for the girls. Elsie. Yes, Miss Burgess. I thought you'd like to help me up on stage, making sure that lights are properly handled and prompting if necessary. Are you willing to be stage manager?
Willing. I'm relieved.
Then you may take a seat at my table.
Yes. Finally get to sit at this table.
Now, Sylvia, since you have been in Mr. Carter's art classes, and on his recommendation, I have decided to put you in charge of costumes
and makeup. You may also take a seat at my table. This is the production table.
Oh, thank God, no more memorizing.
Now, Lori.
I debated about you for a long time. I thought with your journalism experience that you should be in charge of publicity.
Lori's a great little journalist, Miss Burgess.
But I had decided to let Joan White take care of that side of the
Yeah,
country.
Joan!
Hurry! Hurry! I don't have to learn a line.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Now for the hand of young grandpa. That would be a pretty little cousin from the north. Cousin Henrietta. I think that Janet Young will make a very attractive young villain.
She sure should, Miss Burgess.
Now, Nancy.
Yes, Miss Burgess.
Your role takes a great deal of ability and charm. You will be playing the mother to the heroine, Mrs. Marquis. I certainly don't know anyone else that can play it better than you.
Then, that means...
Lori, this leaves the part of Belinda for you. It is definitely the longest part there is. It's not necessarily the most difficult. Congratulations.
Oh my gosh!
I felt it in my bones.
I felt it in my
bones! Lori, I knew you'd get the part!
Thank you! Thank you, Burgess! Thank you very much!
Lori, no need to thank me, Lori. It's the role I thought you'd do best. Now take your seats, everyone.
Okay.
Miss Burgess, does Lori and I have many scenes together? Two scenes?
Quite a few, yes.
Then perhaps we can find some time for some extra rehearsals. To get our lines right, I mean.
Your line's too straight and fast as is, Jocko. Don't get any fancy ideas. I might have to.
Andy, will you do me a favor?
Because I don't like the smell of this whole thing. You're just too darn smooth for my taste.
Nobody asked you about your taste, Fulbright.
Andy, I'm speaking to you. Will you go to my room and bring the playbooks back here?
Right now?
Would you please?
I'll go, but under protest. Just because she's stage struck temporarily. Don't you get any fancy ideas. That's a warning. I'll do anything to stop it. Anything.
You and Andy going steady.
Jocko, is that any of your business?
Well, not officially, but he's made me so mad today.
Jocko, did you hear me?
Because I'm not going steady either. And we don't want any childish jealousy getting between us.
Jocko! Miss Burgess, may I please be excused? I'll pick up my playbook in 207. I have to talk to Mr. Snyder about the upcoming debate.
What just happened then?
Wowee! I go for that Nancy gal. Some spirit, huh, Jocko?
Well, Milt, I'm quite glad to hear you say that. Does this mean that you wouldn't mind bringing my playbook around my house tonight? Unless you have something more important to do.
No, sir. I mean, no, ma'am. Can't think of nothing I got going on this evening near as important as bringing your playbook around your little house this very night.
I think I just a little...
Nancy, you may be excused. I see little more to do today anyways.
Thank you, Miss Burgess.
Good riddance.
And Lori, if I didn't say so before, congratulations.
Thanks.
Let it go out of the others, Miss Burgess.
Yes, I've excused her.
Bad practice. Now, Miss Stevens, who's putting on these here plays ahead of you, she never let anybody leave ahead of anybody else.
I imagine I'll do a number of things differently than her, Mr. Peterson.
Miss Stevens put on some mighty fine shows around here.
I'm sure she did. However,
you ain't got high blood pressure, have you?
Why, no, I...
That's what Miss Stevens had. Poor thing, just had to throw in the towel. Kid's got too much for her.
Mr. Peterson, are you sweeping in here?
Sweeping? Nah, man. I'm just looking things over. I don't do any sweeping in the morning, neither. I go out at 5. That means there can't be no messing up with things between now and 5 o'clock. Miss Stevens always cooperated on that.
I'm sure that we can all cooperate on that. I'll take full responsibility of the neatness of the stage, and I have full confidence in every one of these students here.
You do, huh? That's buying up a mighty big chew, that is. Where do you want me to sit?
Sit, Mr. Peterson?
Yeah. There's nothing like better than watch a bunch of fool kids make bigger fools of themselves.
I'm afraid you don't sit anywhere, Mr. Peterson. I do not allow anyone to witness a rehearsal. It makes the actor self-conscious.
Self-conscious? Nowadays? You ain't had your eyes open lately. There's a self-conscious kid left on the face of the earth. Not since we started that progressive education stuff.
Well, even if you are to be right, Mr. Peterson, your own attitude towards these boys and girls, you wouldn't make a very sympathetic audience.
I won't so much as breathe.
Well, Mr. Peterson, if you were to breathe for an entire rehearsal, I don't think that would be too good for your blood pressure. So, I'm afraid that if you're not working in here, you leave us.
You want to start making enemies this early in the game? I'm willing. Only someone's going to be sorry around here. It ain't going to be old Tony. You're gonna be sorry for embarrassing me in front of all those kids! Oh, you're gonna be sorry. Sweet. Don't hang teachers like they used to.
Should I report him to the principal? Do you suppose that was a threat?
Mind old Tony. He kind of thinks he runs the school.
Here we are! Good afternoon, everyone! Don't let me interrupt a thing! Just go right along as if I wasn't even present. I'll just sit here until you're ready for me, Miss Burgess. We can talk about the costumes anytime at all at your convenience. Thank you, Sylvia! Proceed! Just ignore me entirely.
I'll be free, Miss Moran, as soon as the playbooks arrive.
What?! You mean you're sending them home without even reading the script with them?
I want them to form their own impressions over the week. Then we'll discuss.
Wrong! Completely off on the wrong foot. Miss Stevens always read the entire play with the cast, line by line. And she had some very successful productions. Believe you me, Miss Burgess. Not that I'm criticizing. I would open my mouth. I'll just sit right here and not so much as say another word. It's your play. Do it your way. And of course, take the consequences.
Thank you, Miss Moran. I'm sure we'll all be grateful for any advice that you and your home economics class can give to us on the costumes.
Of course, a period play does present problems. Civil War costumes. My word. We'll be working day and night, not that I'm criticizing. Don't you think it for a minute. If it's Civil War costumes you want, it's Civil War costumes you'll get. And that's a promise.
Thank you, Miss Moran. Now, why don't you girls join us over here for the present?
Okay, Miss Burgess. Hey, Miss Burgess.
Hey, guys. I'm Beth.
Now, I want you to read your scripts. Not only just your role, I want you to form your own idea of what the author was trying to say.
May I have a copy of the script, Miss Burgess?
As soon as Andy arrives with the playbooks, of course you may. Thank you.
So
now, as I was saying, I want you to form your own ideas, especially on the character you are about to portray. I want to hear all about them Monday afternoon.
You already lost today! And there's only 4 weeks, you know, and one day's a holiday. That only leaves 19 rehearsal days until the night of the production. Oh, I'm glad the weight's not on my shoulders.
The weight, Miss Moran, is growing steadily heavier on mine.
Oh, I don't doubt it. I don't. Stevens, who used to direct our productions for years and years. Oh, she always lost 10 pounds during rehearsals, the poor soul.
Yeah, but 10 pounds more or less on Miss Stevens had no effect whatsoever.
Is that Milton Sanders? I didn't hear what little witticism he had to offer, but I can tell you this, Miss Burgess. You have not been very careful in the selection of your cast.
Good afternoon.
Hello, Norman.
Good afternoon, Mr. Carter. Won't you join us?
Thank you, ladies. So these are the hams. How are your kids doing?
Pretty good.
My journalism class are handling the publicity, I understand. Have you appointed anyone to take charge?
Joan White is going to be in charge.
Good choice.
And I'll be taking care of designing the costumes, just like last year, and the year before, and the year before that. Won't it be great to work together again, Norman?
Why, Mary, yes, of course, that is...
What a technique!
I could have learned that when I was a freshman.
Isn't Mr. Carter the cutest thing?
He's actually blushing.
I'm pretty busy right now, with the school yearbook. But if you're free for dinner, it might give us a better chance to discuss the procedure. And to get better acquainted, too.
Well, in that case, I imagine I'm simply in the way! I wouldn't want to interfere, I'm sure!
More green ash around this place all of a sudden.
I don't see anything else to do today. Now, suppose you go and see what happened to Andy in the playbooks. I'll see you 3:30 Monday on this stage. Have a nice weekend.
You too, Miss Burgess. You too, Miss Burgess.
Oh, 8:07 before nightfall or bust.
Shut up, Bills. Aren't they, though?
What are you doing? Janet, let go!
Miss Burgess, I just want to thank you again for my part. I have a feeling this will be the most exciting experience. I only hope I can do what you expect.
I'm sure you will, Lori.
I can't wait to read the play. There's something about a stage. A theater. I don't know what it is, but my heart's going a mile a minute. What will my costume be like, Miss Burgess? Will it be long and exotic and glamorous and... I'm sorry. You're in a hurry. It's just... I never knew. Why? Even the smell of the theater is exciting.
More exciting than the smell of ink and paste in an editorial room, eh, Lori?
Lori, our job here is to... give a school play. And, well, you know, I don't want you to get any wrong ideas about it. Miss Burgess, you talk just like Andy. I thought you respected Andy's opinions.
I do. I mean, I did?
Oh, I don't know, Miss Burgess.
Andy always strikes me as a pretty smart sort of fellow.
I only hope that he doesn't know you better than I do, Lori. He thinks I'm stage struck.
Oh, Andy's just sore because Lori got the lead. I'm sure he's walked off in a huff without even bothering about the playbooks at all.
I doubt that Andy would do that, Jocko.
You never know. Lori, how would you like to come down to the Civic Theater tonight and we'll see the show? I have a very fine part.
Oh, I don't believe I could, Jocko.
You can watch it from backstage.
Backstage?
And meet all the actors, and the director, too.
Oh, Jocko! I love it!
You know, you're even more beautiful when you are excited like this.
Stop it!
Making it rough, are they?
Not exactly, but I'm afraid I have a budding Sarah Bernhardt on my hands there. And Miss Moran! What's she thinking? And in front of the students, too.
It sounds egotistic to tell you, but I'm afraid Carolyn fancies herself in love.
With you?
Is that so hard to imagine?
No, I didn't mean it that way.
Carolyn and I have attended various faculty functions throughout the years. until you came this term. We were only two relatively young and unmarried members of this faculty.
I see.
But that's as far as it goes, or at least as far as I'm concerned. So will you have dinner with me to discuss the publicity, of course?
I'm afraid I'm busy, Mr. Carter.
Carolyn Moran scare you off?
I don't get easily scared, Mr. Carter. But the truth is that I'm trying to get along with everyone, and without much success either. Like, even the janitor's my own sworn enemy.
Old Tony, all you have to do is bark louder than he does.
I'm afraid I did, and he resents it. Why, he even threatened us, the production that is.
This, all this is really important to you, isn't it?
Yes, it's the first production that I get to have complete charge of. And I love working with students. It's all I've ever wanted to do. I love Riverview too. I love it more and more every day.
I hope that includes the journalism teacher here too.
I hope so too.
My name's Norman. Please have dinner with me.
Well, if it is business.
After all, with all the extracurricular work we have to find some time to mix pleasure with business, don't we?
Do you know where I live?
Yes.
You do?
I looked it up in the office records several weeks ago.
But why?
I may tell you at dinner at 7, and I may not.
You know, Norman, for the first time, I feel, well, relieved, relaxed, as though someone is certainly on my side.
See you tonight, Irene.
In the short amount of time that we have, I think we'll make it.
Miss Burgess! Well, what in the world are you doing sitting in here all alone?
You have no idea how peaceful it is by myself.
Well, I have a bunch of allies for the production, Miss Burgess. And I'm sure I brought them along on my way home. I'm sure they're in here somewhere. As senior sponsor, of course, I did feel it my duty to go over the figures you'd submitted and to reduce them just a trifle here and there. Now, if I could just... I'm sure I put them in here somewhere. Aha! I cut the budget in half, Miss Burgess, right down the middle. Don't ask me how I managed, but I did.
Yes, you certainly managed.
You know, I'm very glad to have this opportunity to speak with you in private. I just want you to know that even in my capacity as senior sponsor, I have no intention whatever of interfering.
Yes, of course, Miss Rivers.
But it has just come to my attention that you've cast Loretta Fowler as the leading role.
Yes, I did.
Well, of course, it's none of my business, but Miss Stevens, you've heard of Miss Stevens, haven't you? Your predecessor?
Yes. I've heard that name many, many times this afternoon.
Well, Miss Stevens was always grateful for my suggestions. Our theories would just coincide completely. I'm surprised that Nancy wasn't giving the leading role.
Nancy has a very important role. I just didn't think that she could fit the ingenue role that Lori Fuller has, in my opinion.
Nancy can do anything she sets her mind to. Her father, you know, is president of the Riverview Bank. And her mother, poor child, has been dead for years. But Mr. Leverage has done an excellent job. He's a very successful man, and his daughter will grow up to be just like him. If Nancy were to have the leading role, it would give her a clean sweep of all the important school honors in her senior year.
Don't you think that the honors should be spread around a bit? Although, I wouldn't let the idea go one way or the other if I thought you were the girl for the role. By giving the best production that I can give, I feel as though I'm doing the best for everyone in the school and the school itself.
That's one theory, I've heard it. Nancy is very disappointed, you know.
Between you and I, don't you think that Nancy should receive a few disappointments in life? Or else she'll be in for some heavy shocks later, won't she?
I happen to disagree. Mr. Leverage is going to be appalled when he learns that Lori was chosen for that part. Miss Burgess, you may think, being young and sure of yourself, that you can get along without any help. But let me assure you,
problems will arise, you know. They will arise.
And you know it.
How dare you take that tone of voice with me, Mr. Carter? I don't even know what you're doing here anyway.
I came back to ask if I could drive you home, but I didn't expect this.
Neither did I. You know, or should know, how important Lori's scholarship and job is to me. And, well, if I knew it was going to upset those plans, and she's a free human being, and she can make her own decisions, even if the wrong ones.
All for a lot of silly theatrical foolishness?
I'm with you, Mr. Carter. You tell him.
Andy! Foolishness? Silly theatrical? So that's what you think we're doing here?
Miss Burgess, Mr. Carter, this is hardly a time for a discussion of educational theory. Now, I shall report this occurrence to the principal's office at once if I do not telephone him tonight. Meanwhile, Miss Burgess, I hold you entirely responsible.
I'm sorry, Irene. I didn't mean to add dirt.
I'm afraid I'm busy after all, Mr. Carter.
But Irene, listen.
Goodbye, Mr. Carter.
Oh. Well, all right. All right.
Oh. There you are, Norman. I was hoping you might give me a ride home.
It would be my pleasure.
Miss Moran, have you seen the playbooks?
I? How should I have seen them?
Well, I thought you might have gone to go pick up your playbook.
They've been stolen, Miss Moran.
Stolen? And you think I? Are you accusing? Oh,
no, I didn't mean.
Every time I walk in here, it gets louder. Anything I can do?
I'll lay even money on old Tony.
What's that?
Well, someone's certainly trying to sabotage things.
That's right. Remember how sore Tony was when he left here last time?
He even warned he might do something.
Watch this. Can't hear you. He's been on me a lot.
Spill it, Tony. Where'd you hide him?
Hide what?
Tony didn't do it, but I know who did and why. You thought a postponement would stop me, didn't you?
Listen, Lori, if you fall into that line of Jocko's, I don't give a hang what you do.
Quiet, everybody! The play is going on as scheduled. I wouldn't want a little silly theatrical foolishness to get in the way of more important things. I'll type copies over the weekend. I'll help.
Lori, you can't. We have a date tomorrow night.
Oh, but don't you remember, Andy? You don't give a hang what I do.
Use your head. I was excited.
Miss Burgess, I can type too.
Type? I bet you can knit.
I can also take care of myself right anytime.
Here now! None of that, you two! Break it up! And I mean it! Shall I take you home now, Carolyn?
Yes! I've never been so insulted in my life!
Let's go, Lori.
Just a minute. I believe you have an ID bracelet that belongs to me.
I most certainly do! Dead!
Alright now, kids. I'm gonna pull the curtain, clear the stage. Come on, frame, frame. Come on.
Stop it, that's the
stop.
Oh,
get out.
Likely that you entered through the house?
could follow Laura around with a flashlight on her face throughout the show. That way, nobody will miss even a flicker of her fake eyelashes.
My eyelashes are not fake!
Well, everything else is, all of a sudden.
There'll be enough of this, Andy. Now let's get on with rehearsal. Places!
Hello, Miss Belinda. Look kind of depressed. Your mother thought you might be cheered by these here magnolias. Is that right, Miss Burgess?
Bill, I'll stop you if it's too bad. Now go on.
Y'all wanna like some tea and popovers? Would y'all, Miss Belinda?
No, Luke. Thank you.
I got to say, Miss Belinda, you sure do have your troubles. First, Master Randolph coming back wounded from this here civil war. Next, this plantation is about to be sold at auction. It'll be better in makeup.
Go on with rehearsal, please.
Feel like Amos and Andy, all roll together.
Come on.
Miss Burgess, is this me?
Yes, Buck, it's you.
Okay.
I could use a hat pin, Miss Burgess.
A hat pin? Whatever for?
Well, it'd get him on, wouldn't it?
Now, come on, Elsie.
Little Belinda!
Owen Hamilton! Owen Hamilton of all people!
Little Belinda, I heard all these Savannah your troubles, and I'm here to straighten matters out. But first, my little sheriff, how about...
What is it now, Buck?
Kiss!
What?
The line is, but first, my little sheriff, how about a kiss?
I know the line, Elsie.
Uh-huh.
It's just something freezes up in here. Laryngitis, I think.
Laryngitis every time he has to say the word kiss?
It's not that! It's...
Uh-huh.
I don't know. Something happens. I just... It won't come out.
Amateur!
And what are you? A professional?
Yes. Obviously. All right. Now, Buck, this happens to many young actors. This is a form of stage fright. I only hope that by the night of performance, we will have rehearsed it so many times that this cannot happen.
You're right, Miss Burgess.
Meanwhile, what were you doing with your hands just then? What did it mean?
Oh, you mean this? Well, because, you know, I thought Owen Hamilton, being imported from Savannah, he might want a couple tobacco fields too. So I figured he'd be smoking a cigar. That's all I was doing, Miss Burgess. Smoking a cigar.
There'll be no smoking, Buck.
But it wouldn't be me actually smoking. It'd be Owen Hamilton, because you know, I'm in training.
For a while now, you'll have the same lungs, Buck. Now let's give your voice a break. And let's start from that Lori and Randolph scene.
I'm ready, Miss Burns.
Of course you are!
Places!
Goodbye, Owen! I'll think about it!
I know the line, Elsie.
Whatever.
I'll think about it.
Belinda! Who is that riding down the road? Horse kicking up a powerful lot of dust.
Oh, Grandma! Darling, it was Owen Hamilton, of all people.
Owen Hamilton.
And he came all the way from Savannah to ask for my hand in marriage.
The dog.
Yeah. More dramatic. Yes, isn't he just? But what can I do? What will I do?
You are gonna do what we always say we were gonna do. I don't care if your entire fortune has been destroyed by Yankees and blue weevils.
Well, marry me.
Yes. You are gonna marry me.
But Randolph, you are as poor as we are, and Father worries night and day. What can I do? What will I do? Mr. Hamilton offers to buy up the plantation and save us all if I will but consent to be his bride.
Owen Hamilton made a fortune with running guns. You wouldn't look twice at a man like that.
You are right, Randolph.
Andy, what are you doing?
He doesn't come on here.
But I think he would. Miss Burgess, do you think Belinda's father would leave her alone in the garden with two different men like that? Maybe today, but this is after the Civil War, remember?
Andy, I don't precisely remember. I didn't write the play, neither did you, so you'll have to wait for your cue.
Hey, Andy. Your cue is when Jocko kisses Laurie.
Miss Burgess, are you gonna let him kiss like that? On stage in front of a couple thousand people?
Oh my god.
It's the only kiss in the play, Andy. I doubt anyone will object.
Well, I do.
Amateurs.
Andy, you're making a spectacle of yourself.
I'm making a spectacle of myself? And what about you? I don't care how people think about me. I know how I feel, and that matters to me. But you, you're so mixed up, you don't even act like yourself anymore.
Andy, there'll be enough of that. No one can rehearse in all this confusion.
What was that? What was that?
What was that?
What was that?
It works! It works!
What was that?
The thunder machine for the storm. Isn't it lovely? And look, the guns, the dueling pistols.
Just don't let Andy get a hold of one of those in the mood he's in.
Here's the gun I killed Buck with.
Jocko!
Jocko, put that away. Sylvia, put these things away. I don't want to see any of them out until dress rehearsal. Is that clearly understood?
Yes, Miss Burgess.
I don't want to see any accidents. And if someone disobeys these rules, then I will have to automatically relinquish the role at once.
Lori, you
want to
touch the guns a little bit?
No, I don't.
I don't need a gun to take care of Jocko.
How I detect jealous men.
Why don't you face facts? You weren't like this 4 weeks ago. Why, now you eat it up. Why, you'd enjoy it if someone actually dueled over you.
I might remind you, Mr. Fulbright, that you no longer have any right to speak to me in this manner.
In this manner? Listen to her, will you?
Clear the stage! Let's get on with rehearsal!
Okay.
Miss Burgess?
Yes, Mr. Carter?
I know it's a bad time, but we're having trouble getting the photos in the feature story. Could you spare 10 minutes to discuss the publicity?
Why, yes, of course. Now, everyone, let's take a 10-minute break. Don't go any farther than the band room. There'll be sodas in the cooler. Shall we go outside, Mr. Carter?
If you'd like.
I must apologize to you, Mr. Carter, for the way I behaved when the playbooks disappeared last Friday. You will forgive me, won't you?
As a matter of fact, I won't. I'm not here to discuss that.
Whoa. What's gotten into Mr. Carter? Boy, any gal as pretty as Miss Burgess begs me to forgive her like that? Brother, I forgive her. There's a fight brewing here. I'm staying. Get out of here, Milt.
So yes, sir. I was just going.
Well, Jocko, coming, darling?
Not just yet. Lori, this would be a perfect chance for us to go over our lines together.
What lines? Your line's too smooth already.
Oh, Andy, run along and buy a 7-Up.
One of these days, Lori, you're gonna push me. You're gonna push me just too darn far.
And then what'll happen?
You better not be around to find out.
Andy, haven't you done enough to sabotage the production?
Tell me, what have I done? Tell me what?
Taking those playbooks
In the hope of Miss Burgess have to postpone the show?
I didn't.
Cutting in when you didn't have a cue? Trying to rewrite the play?
Listen, Lloyd, for the last time, I didn't take the books.
When you went out of here that day, you said you'd do anything, and you did.
If you didn't take the playbooks, then tell me, what were you doing all that time?
I told you, I took a lot to cool off, trying to decide.
Yes, Andy? Trying to decide what?
Trying to decide, if you must know, whether you were the same gal I used to know. Trying to dope out with all this Betty Davis hullabaloo was on the square. You used to know where you're going. But now, you act like these mixed up maniacs.
Well, Mr. Fulbright, since you're so dissatisfied with my nature.
That's what I mean. That Mr. Fulbright business. That attitude from that altitude. I just can't take it.
There's no law, Andy, that says you have to. Is there? Please don't quarrel anymore over these darn playbooks.
This goes a lot deeper than the playbooks.
Yes, I think it does.
Tell you what, let's all grab a Coke and cool down.
Excellent idea, Jocko.
No Coke will ever cool me down. I've never been so mad in my life. I may never be this mad again. First, she accuses me of stealing. Then, after 6 months of going steady, she says I have no say in her turning into a ham-like Jocko.
Ham!
I said ham, and I mean ham. You smell.
Well, Mr. Fulbright!
Oh, I'm warning you, don't call me that again.
Well, Mr. Fulbright! Since this is the way you fundamentally feel, don't you think you have a miserable time dancing with a hair? Believe me! I don't believe you should take me to homecoming tonight!
Oh, I'll take you all right.
I wouldn't think of it!
I said I would. After all, it's too late for you to get another date.
For me to get another! For me!
A guy can always stag it.
Oh, is that what you're all you're after?
That's it. You sit at home and watch television.
Oh, you want a bet?
I'll stag it. I'll dance with every pretty girl in sight. I'll...
And that's what you've been after all this time!
I didn't.
Then prove it! You've just been looking for a bet!
How a woman could reach a conclusion like that from a discussion like this. Now I know what my father says when he says to argue with a woman is like having a fist fight with a revolving door.
Jocko, I'm thirsty!
Oh, yes, Jocko! Go and take poor little Lizzie and get her a cup! I'll just sit here by myself and study my lines. Looks like I have a lot of lonely days ahead of me and nights.
I don't think you'll have to worry long, Lori.
That's easy for you to say, Jocko. You have a date to homecoming. And even if you didn't, a man can stag it. The cards are all stacked against a woman. That's what my mother means when she says a woman doesn't stand a chance in this man's world.
I wouldn't say that, although I had no idea this would come up.
You had no idea this would come up? Or what? What would you have done?
I wish you wouldn't get so excited, Nancy.
Who's excited? I just want to know what you mean. If you think that I'm going to go to homecoming with you, all the while knowing you'd rather be with somebody else, someone sitting at home watching television, if you think...
Can you tell me why everyone is getting so excited? Everyone except you and me.
Everything seems so childish. Sometimes a person just needs a chance to stand off and really see people and things for the first time. People they've known for a long time. People they just imagined they knew all along.
If you want to make a crack, say it straight. We can all do without the phony acting.
Oh, why don't you just go jump in a lake?
That's it. That's the girl I like. That makes sense.
Then why don't you just do it?
Ow.
Serves you right.
What did you say?
I said it serves you right.
That's what I thought you said.
What's a big idea, bully?
Well, you had it coming, Jocko.
What? You make as much sense as Lori does.
He had it coming, but you had no right to do it.
That does it! Since I had it coming, Lori, I suddenly find I don't have a date for homecoming tonight.
Jocko, did he hurt you?
Oh, no, you don't! You can't break our date! I've already broken it.
So will you go with me then?
Why, Jocko? I love it. It'll be so much more fun than sitting home and watching television. So much more fun. Way more fun.
Did I tell you, my aunt, who's a big actress on Broadway, is heading down to watch the performance?
No.
I've written her all about you.
Him and his aunt.
How do you like that? She not only steals the leading role away from me, but she steals my boyfriend!
Do you really care about that stewed turnip?
I don't know anymore. I don't know anything.
You know if you did, the way I know. Even when I'm maddest, I guess it's love. She's making a mistake, Nancy, a real mistake. Next thing you'll know, she'll be running off to Broadway with that.
Don't worry, Andy. It won't happen.
Yeah, you'll see. How?
I don't know how yet, but I'm not licked. I'll find a way.
Oh, sure. You'll find, you'll what?
I'm not stymied quite so easily. If one thing doesn't work, there's always another.
You.
But I'll tell you one thing. I'm going to play that role.
You didn't.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Last Friday, you went up to H07. You took the books.
You'll never prove it.
I don't want to prove it. Only, why, Nancy? Why?
If the play had been postponed, then Lori wouldn't have been able to be in it, would she?
Because of the journalism conference. But that's not what I mean. I mean, how could you do such a thing, no matter how much you wanted that role?
I don't know how, Andy. I just did. That's how important this role is to me. I can't explain, Andy. I've had the most miserable week of my life.
Golly, I ought to be as sore as the devil. You know they're blaming me, don't you?
That's one of the reasons I've been so miserable. That, and it hasn't been easy at home.
Your father?
My father is the most wonderful man in the world.
All right. Say, how about you and I go to homecoming together?
Oh, Andy, you're just saying that because you feel sorry for me, aren't you?
Gosh, no. I feel sorry for myself. I hate sagging a dance.
Oh, Andy, you're sweet, but you're lying. I don't want to go with someone just because they feel sorry for me. Andy, I wouldn't blame you if you reported me.
I wouldn't do that.
No, you wouldn't. You really are one of the nicest guys I ever met. Just get a bright idea for publicity. How do you like this? I'll write a piece in the school paper about the fall play cast at homecoming. I guess I know who you two are going with.
I'm going with Milt Sanders.
Milt Sanders? But he said he was stagging it.
Well, he doesn't know he's taking me yet, but he will.
What's with Nancy and Jocko?
Joan, do you have a date for homecoming?
You too?
How about it? I already ordered corsage.
Look, I'm going with Floyd McCutcheon, and he's even more jealous than you are. So, watch out.
I figured you already have a date.
I don't get this. What about Jocko and Lori?
Andy, don't tell me.
Okay, I won't. You'll only find out soon enough.
Jocko and Lori, two leads. What a publicity story.
Be sure to put it on page 1.
I'll have a photographer there. And the night of the performance,
when he kisses her on stage, the audience won't know whether it's real or not. Like Zeta Jones and Douglas. Oh, brother. Now I can do a job.
Joan,
hmm?
You're not bad.
I mean, what did you say?
I guess I never really noticed before.
Andy, stop teasing.
I'm not teasing, honest. Say, what are you doing tonight?
Tonight?
Yes, tonight.
Why, I'm not doing a thing.
Oh yes you are. You're going to homecoming with me. I've been blind too long.
Yeah, and then he said, and that's how I saved Christmas. But anyhow, seriously, my father has an aversion to fun. He enjoys trigonometry. Trigonometry! Do you hear me? And the lower my pig has its up. And the lower my grade goes, the more he says he used to enjoy it. But don't tell Miss Burgess. Don't want to get her upset.
But, Milt, why would it upset Miss Burgess?
I'm flunking.
Yeah. Flunking?
And if I flunk, I can't be in the play. So don't tell her. She might get upset or something.
Aren't you upset?
Me? I can't afford to get upset. I've got to keep my mind clean for trigonometry, of course.
Well, Mill, it just so happens that trigonometry is one of my best and easiest subjects.
Yeah, but you don't have my father.
I'm saying, Mill, perhaps I could help you.
Coach me a little, you mean?
I'd be willing to, Mill.
Kid, you got yourself a date.
Tonight?
Yeah, but tonight's the
dance. I know! We can talk about it while we dance.
I don't know. Maybe tomorrow night.
Do you already have a date?
No, it's not that. But it's like this. A fellow gets a certain reputation, you see. He's got to live up to it. Me? I got a reputation for being a wolf. Ah, wolf! But, and I gotta live up to it. Besides, one date sort of cramps my style. I like to dance with all the beautiful women, to spread my charm around.
All people!
Milt, the lady is offering you a date.
And I'm glad too, don't get me wrong.
Only don't be complete dope. You wanna pass trait, don't you? You wanna be in the play. Don't you?
Nancy, how would you like to go to homecoming with me?
I'd love it!
Okay.
All I'm asking is for you to listen to me, Irene.
I'm too busy now.
What happened there? When they went out of here, she was practically begging his forgiveness for something. Now look at him.
Irene, at least let me explain.
Is everyone here?
We're all present, Miss Burgess.
Sadly.
Rare to go.
Great. Then let's start with that Belinda and Randolph scene again. Laces!
I do think I deserve an explanation for why you won't see me away from the school. If it was because there was someone else, or if you were engaged, or if you weren't attracted to me at all.
Do you want the students to hear? The truth is, but I don't want to make an enemy of Miss Moran.
Carolyn Moran?
Yes, Carolyn Moran. And don't act so surprised. Why, even the entire faculty thinks you're on the verge of being engaged.
But that's ridiculous. Carolyn and I are friends. I already told you that. If you think I'm going to let myself be pushed into an engagement with her...
It doesn't matter in the least what I think. It's what everyone else thinks.
Couldn't my energy have to do with what I think?
Oh, Miss Moran!
Yes! Miss Moran indeed! And in person! I can't
you that my classes simply cannot master the trick of tailoring a Confederate uniform. I came to ask whether we could move the play to the North after the Civil War.
Oh, Tamara!
But since you have humiliated me in front of the entire class, I'm now going to ask the principal to release me from this assignment. Give me proper costumes! Remember yourself!
Carolyn! I don't think... She doesn't mean... I'll talk to Carolyn!
Excuse me, Miss Burgess. The doors are in place. Do you want to take a look?
I'd love to. Marcy, open the curtain. Tiffany, I love them. Marcy, keep the curtains open.
Thank you, Miss Burgess. We'll finish the rest of the set now.
Wonderful. You ready now, Miss Burgess?
Please, Elsie.
Blazes!
Miss Burgess...
What is it now, Andy?
I only want to say, I'm sorry for the way I acted earlier. Now, I don't give a hang who kisses who. I just don't care.
Stop it. What do you say, Miss Burgess?
It doesn't matter, Lori.
What do you say, Andy Fulbright?
I said, for your information, I don't care who kisses you, or how many times, or how many people are out there snickering.
Andy, there'll be enough of that. Can you believe that?
Well, ready when you are.
Go, Blazes!
Okay, guys, come on.
Anytime I see a gun lying around, I think it's my duty to check up on it. To bring it a blank cartridge.
Hey, stop it!
A blank cartridge? Fired at close range? Can injure someone. If the wad hasn't been removed, then little black things can embed themselves into the skin.
I know. Tell them, not me. You know, Miss Stevens never put any plays with any killing in them. You think I'm killing somebody? Hiding to the ceiling anyways. Dangerous business. Letting adolescents run out of loaded guns. Oh, look at me. Bang, bang. Oh.
Now, Sylvia. I put you in charge of props. Now, if something happens like this again, I'll have to find someone else to replace you.
Lori can do it.
You don't care, did you say? Wait till you see me kiss Jocko. Just wait.
Are you speaking to me?
Yes, I am.
Ow.
Elsie, get ready for the beginning of the scene.
Okay, Miss Burgess.
Places, everyone.
Miss Burgess? May I be excused for the day? My eyes.
I'm sorry, Jocko, but we must get on with rehearsal. How'd you do that anyway?
Man, I'd rather not say.
Nice shiner, Jocko!
Clear the stage! Get on with rehearsal! Guys, off! Off!
Miss Burgess?
Not again, Buck!
Laryngitis, I think.
Buck.
I can't talk.
Nancy could learn mine.
We'll discuss this later, Nancy.
Elsie, okay.
Learn my name before you learn her lines. This is ridiculous.
We'll discuss this later, Nancy.
You never know what could happen.
Later, Nancy.
I just wanted you to know I know all of her lines.
Will you take your place at once, Nancy?
Yeah.
Owen Hamilton leaves me no choice. I have no choice. I must go through with it.
But Randolph!
Sorry. But Randolph, he may kill you!
That, Belinda, is a chance a gentleman must take in these matters. I must go through with it.
Just a moment. What in heaven's name are you doing with that pencil?
Sorry, I missed my cue, Miss Burgess.
That hardly answers my question, Lori.
These are the proofs for the yearbook. I have to have the corrected copies and to the printers by the time he closes this evening. Mr. Carter's orders.
Well, you certainly can't do them the night of dress rehearsal. You do know it's dress rehearsal. Don't you?
Sorry, Miss Burgess.
Well, hurry, go put them on stage, quickly.
Yes, ma'am. Miss Burgess.
Yes, Doc?
Well, there's something here in the script that mixes me up, where it says, Owen goes to Brown's study.
Yes.
Well, the trellis leads to the road, and the doors lead to the parlor. But what mixes me up is, which way's the Brown study? What are you laughing at, Bruce Willis?
Let Elsie explain it. Now go on with rehearsal.
Come on, bud.
God, when the team gets one look at me in this getup, I might as well quit school.
I have no choice. This must be settled on the field of honor.
But Randolph, a duel with a notorious killer like Owen Hamilton, you must think of the consequences. Is it bad enough with all that's happened to us here? The plantation up for auction, the entire crop destroyed by the pearl people.
Miss Burgess, this play must have been written 50 years ago.
Or more.
Everybody's gonna laugh when Lori says that and ruins the whole scene.
Guys. I'm sorry, Jocko. I didn't get to select this play. Next year, if I'm still at Riverview, I'll be sure to choose a present-day play with modern-day people. Meanwhile, Lori, while you get rid of the part about the Boolimals, I doubt the play selection committee will miss it.
Got it.
What the heck was that?
Again?
Not again.
What was that?
Who did that thunder noise?
Seriously?
We'll miss it. That's the cue, isn't it? When you say that, I cue for the thunder.
Watch the script, Elsie.
Well, how can I watch the script when Buck keeps asking me where the Brown study is?
I'm sorry! God!
No, Boolimals! No thunder! No Brown study! Now go away with rehearsal! Please!
Guys, places!
I have no choice, Belinda. Owen Hamilton leaves me no choice.
Where is that slow-moving creature?
Where is he?
Only Luke can show up.
Miss Belinda, your cousin Miss Henrietta's arrived from Charleston.
Cousin Henrietta? Here?
Yes, in there. Miss Burgess, I keep forgetting. Is this where I take three steps down like this, or is that later?
No. Tonight's dress rehearsal. Tomorrow night's
I know. I might not be out here tomorrow night either.
What?
Mills? What do you mean by that?
Well, it's like this. You can't be in the play if you're flunking even one subject, right?
Mills, are you flunking one subject?
No, ma'am.
Well, then...
I'm flunking two. But you know, the one that counts is trigonometry. And Nancy's been helping me nearly every evening. But we had our test this morning. And Miss Vanderpark is correcting papers right now. Well, just don't be surprised if I can't be in the play.
I wouldn't be surprised at anything. Now go on with rehearsal.
Just thought it was fair to warn you. Yes'm, in there. Here they come now.
Now, Henrietta, how long was your train out here?
It was forever and ever.
It must have been terrible.
Well, I'm glad you're here.
Well, me too.
Cousin Henrietta.
Linda.
Little did I think you'd ever find us in this predicament.
Hush, Belinda. We don't speak of our troubles.
Why, Mama? How calm and fresh you look in spite of all this. And Papa! Miss Burgess, how can I kiss my father if he keeps turning his head like that? If he does it like that tomorrow night, I'll be mortified and the audience will just laugh!
If they do, it'll be the only laugh in the show.
All you, right, Andy. See if you can do it properly.
I'll hold still, but don't expect any cooperation.
No magnolias!
What's that, Mr. Peterson?
No magnolias. The forest don't have them. Don't expect to have them. Just between you and me, you ain't never heard of them. You're in the soup, Miss Burgess.
I'll make a note of it, Miss Burgess, but I can't make any promises.
Thank you, Sylvia.
I wouldn't be in your shoes for twice your salary.
I'll tell Miss Moran. Then she...
Oh, please don't, Sylvia. She's already upset as it is. Now, continue.
Do you want me to kiss my father again?
Yes, please, Lori. And, Andy, don't talk this time.
And Papa!
Where is that slow-moving creature?
Hello, sir. These here, what you mean, Mr. Mockwist, sir?
Oh, no! Now, Belinda, as a true daughter of these states, with a dignity to uphold, you must school yourself against whatever contingency.
But Brandon will be killed! Oh, what happens and we'll kill him! Papa, you cannot let this happen!
You may go, Luke.
Yes, sir, Mr. Marquis. Yes, sir.
Papa, you cannot let Randolph do this! I do not care that old Hamilton has challenged him! I care for nothing but Randolph!
Belinda, you must get hold of yourself!
Thank you, sir. Now I must go. I shall return later. Belinda, your mother is right. I have no choice. This must be settled on the field. Honor.
Papa, what happened? Oh, Mama! Papa! Cousin Henrietta! What happened to him?
Belinda, you're growing hysterical!
Hysterical?
No daughter of mine will lose control of herself like this! And in front of Cousin Henrietta, too!
Oh, don't.
Right out of my head. You showed her how to do it easy, but she just let go.
Burgess.
Now, Lori, try not to make a big deal of this.
Yes, I know, I know. I agree. It certainly seemed like a hard smack to me. But we must remember that Nancy's been terribly upset lately. Our job here is to forget personalities and to work together towards a great performance tomorrow night.
All right, Miss Burgess. That sounds like something I can do. I guess I can take it. If I really grit my teeth.
That's the kind of talk I like to hear, Lori.
Personally, I'm glad you let her have it, Lori. How about you stay out of this, Jocko?
That's what I say, Jocko. This is between Nancy and Lori and Miss Burgess.
Will you listen to them? They're all defending her.
I'm not defending Nancy, Lori, but...
I can't find her anywhere. Guys?
No, why don't you go find her or something? Your department.
I'll go find her. Better than that, I'll go soothe her down. No one knows how soothing I can be when I get going.
Ooh!
Yeah, maybe the men, that is.
Mr. Peterson's right. I'm certainly in the soup.
I disagree wholeheartedly and utterly, Miss Burgess.
What? Who?
Who is that? She come now. Permit me to introduce myself. My name is Kyle Roberts. You've undoubtedly heard of me. Perhaps you've seen me. I do my many performances at the legitimate theater, on the screen, or on television.
I'm Kyle.
Oh.
I'm Kyle. I had no idea you were out there.
Good afternoon, Jocko. I thought to surprise you. And Point One has been in the legitimate theater for as many years as your Aunt Kyle has. One knows better than to interrupt a dress rehearsal. You are fretting needlessly. Dress rehearsals are notoriously bad. It means tonight's performance, opening night, will come off very smoothly.
How do you do, Miss...
Kyle, darling. Kyle will do. Well, darlings, I think you're all going to be great. Every last one of you, great. Simply stupendous. I flew all the way here. It was ghastly, simply ghastly, darlings. Take my advice, stay out of those foul air machines. But I'm here, and I'm glad. I'm especially glad because Miss...
Lori, this is my Aunt Kyle. I told you all
Don't
about...
Don't waste our time, Jocko. This girl and I understand each other. She is a born actress. It reminds me of myself when I was young. It's in every line she reads.
Why, thank you, Miss
Kyle, darling. I've been watching you. You have that certain magic that just takes over the stage.
Miss Roberts, that is Kyle. I'm sure we're all grateful for your kind words, but...
Jocko wrote me about this girl. I said to myself, the boy's infatuated. But I was sadly wrong. She has what it takes, and what's more, she knows it. If you give a performance tomorrow night, one-tenth as good as I think you will. I predict big things. Big, big things beginning for you at once.
Kyle?
Yes, darling.
Our job here is to simply give a school play, not to inject any false ambitions into the cast members.
Is that an insult, darling? I'll pass over it. I've been insulted by professionals.
I don't mean to be insulting. I just didn't know anyone was in the auditorium. I do not allow anyone to witness a rehearsal.
Young lady, with an attitude like that, you're either very, very good or very, very uncertain. Despite your insults, however, I predict that you are very, very good. But I will make myself scarce at once, if not immediately. And Jocko, tomorrow night I'll be out here watching critically.
You had better be good. Jocko, did you hear that?
I knew you would knock her cold, Lori. I never saw her on television.
Lori, I suggest that you forget what she said, at least until after tomorrow night's performance. Now, I'll go try to find Nancy. You will try not to burn down the auditorium while I'm gone, won't you?
Try not to, Miss Burgess.
No promises.
Imagine when I thought it was just terrible today. Imagine!
Don't worry, Lori. You were terrible.
Look who's talking. How many plays have you ever seen in your life, Fulbright?
Enough to know Ham when I smell it.
Lori.
Oh, hello, Joe.
Look, Lori, do you have those proofs ready yet? Mr. Carter and the printer are howling their heads off. Says he can't wait any longer. But I told him our editor hadn't corrected them yet.
It won't take 10 more minutes, Joan. Wait here, and I'll get them for you.
Well, snap it up. How's it going?
Terrible.
Great. By tomorrow night, we'll be in complete shambles.
Where's Milt? I have a message for him from a trig teacher.
What is it, Joan?
I can't speak to anyone but Milt.
But is it good or bad, Joan?
I promise not to speak to anyone else, Janet.
Fine. Sorry. Joan? Did you get them?
Get what?
The proofs. For the yearbook. Did you get them?
How could I get them? I just asked you for them. Remember?
But it's crazy. I took them all straight to when Miss Burgess told me to. And I put them by the chair, by the door. The stage door. And...
Not there!
What? I don't understand it!
First the playbooks, now this. There's a crazy kind of thief roaming around here somewhere.
Andy, do you know anything about
them? Whoa, don't pin this on me again. Why would I want to take the proofs?
Well, if it comes to that, why would someone want to steal them 4 weeks ago?
For Pete's sakes, I...
You what?
Nothing. That is nothing. I don't know.
Well, you're acting pretty suspicious, if you ask me.
Well, who asked you?
Andy, I know you. What are you thinking?
You don't know me. Not since 4 weeks ago. Not ever since this Don Juan character's been whispering Romeo and Juliet to you.
Look, you're all getting off subject. Lori, what are we going to do? If you foul up the yearbook, you won't get your scholarship. And you'll get kicked off the paper even before the term ends, if not worse.
Okay, just don't call Miss Burgess, Joan. I don't care about all that. Whatever happens, just please don't tell Miss Burgess.
Okay. Try not to.
Lori, you can't do this to yourself. This play can't be as important as everything else in the world.
But I can't have Miss Burgess down now, Andy! Don't be unreasonable!
You're being ridiculous, Lori. Nancy already knows your lines and has talked about it. She knows them backwards and forwards, and she has me learning hers.
Nancy! My part!
Well, I'm sorry, but that's what it's gonna come to.
But what are we doing now? Wasting time? Oh. You have to make a dress rehearsal!
I couldn't find Nancy anywhere.
Oh. How do you do, Miss Moran?
I do very well, thank you. But if this was my production, my responsibility, that is, well, I'd be worried.
Pardon me. I need to see a dog. I mean a man.
What?
Miss Moran? Almost, but not quite, but almost. Anything that can happen to a production has happened to me so far. Everyone's a bit jittery. So, since it's not your responsibility, why don't you let me do my own worrying?
Well, of course if you don't want my advice!
At this stage, advice is very cheap.
Oh!
However and nevertheless, I just saw Nancy Lethbridge, and she was in tears.
Tell her to move over.
This is hardly the time for levity.
It's hardly the time for tears either, but I'm on the verge of them.
Or worse. And Nancy told me that while you won't let anyone from the school, such as Mr. Peterson, watch your rehearsal, you have a professional theater person here today.
I didn't
no such thing. Do you think it's quite fair or equal to our educational standards to fill our students with false hopes and misleading ideas about their talents and a professional leader?
Miss Moran, I also don't think it's in the best educational practice to discuss these matters in front of the students. So I suggest that if you have any criticism, you save it until after tomorrow night's performance.
Are you asking me to leave the auditorium?
If you put it that way.
Oh! Then I shall do so at once! And I'll tell his parents about this! Immediately!
Don't worry, Miss Burgess. When they see the show, they'll all feel differently.
I hope so, Lori. I hope so.
I'm sorry, Lori, but I have to tell Miss Burgess.
No, Joan, don't! You can't!
Tell me what, Joan?
Nothing!
That Lori can't be here for a dress rehearsal.
Pardon me if I sit down, will you?
What do you mean, Joan?
Not true! I can't!
She lost the proofs to the yearbook, and they have to be into the printers by this afternoon. If she works all night, she can probably get a new set in the morning.
I can't! I won't!
She's the only one who can do it, Miss Burgess.
It's a conspiracy! Those proofs were stolen!
I wouldn't doubt it, Lori.
I wouldn't doubt anything.
Miss Burgess, you can't ask Lori to give up her part this late. You heard Aunt Kyle. She's going to be terrific.
Well, whether the proofs were lost or stolen, it was Lori's responsibility.
Oh,
I'm sorry, Lori, but this is the way it must be. Nancy can do your role, and Elsie can fill in for Nancy.
I'm sorry.
But this is going to be my chance! Even Miss Roberts said!
I heard Miss Roberts, Lori.
But is impressing her as important as your scholarship? Acting is more important! It's true, Miss Burgess. I never realized until a few weeks ago just what was missing. What I really, honestly wanted to do!
I want you to be in the play. It's important to the play.
But I don't want you to... Jocko, will you go to your dressing room?
But Miss Burgess, this is Lori's chance. Aunt Kyle can help us both to figure things out and straighten them up.
I'm sorry, Jocko, but I want to speak with Lori alone. Everyone, go to your dressing rooms, take off your costumes, then report back here for instructions about tonight's dress rehearsal.
Yes,
really sorry. The play will be ruined.
I'm not so sure it already has been ruined. Joan, can you please leave the stage?
Sure, Miss Burgess.
I'm sorry, Lori.
It was important to you, wasn't it, Miss Burgess? Well, I can always get another job. But I like your review. Well, nothing else can happen.
Why do you want to do
that?
Finished?
Finished? I'm done on both sides. Come through, beat up, and otherwise completely and totally licked. Are you satisfied?
I won't be satisfied. satisfied until you have dinner with me.
Dinner? Dinner? I wouldn't eat up with you?
Yes, with me. Does that sound so horrible?
I wouldn't have dinner with you.
Oh, yes, you will. I should have known this 4 weeks ago.
Let me go. Let me go. No someone should see us.
Well, well, well.
What do you have to say about it, Mr. Peterson?
Nothing, Mr. Carter. Not a thing, sir. Moron shenanigans. I'm a Christmas every year. What they call the Vita. Just wish old Tony could afford to retire. This year, shoe I found. Right there between the seats it was, like it was too tight or too hot. What do you suppose that woman did? Walked up to the cars in a stocking foot? Well, I guess I'll go look for anybody acting suspicious like or nervous in the lobby. Oh, fool, I got your shoe, fool.
Thank you so much.
Loretta Fuller grew up right next door to me, Miss Bridges. But who'd have thought I'd ever see her act like that? Why, she made me believe she's that poor Southern girl. She really did. That Lori ought to be on a professional stage, is what I say. Now where can I find Lori?
The girls' dressing rooms are right off stage over there.
Thank you.
Miss Bridges,
she said maybe don't take this thing off my lip.
Please, just take this off me. I'm gonna get out of here.
I'll show you.
No need to, Norman.
Need to? I want to. It was a fine show.
Thank you. Well, I still haven't heard a word from the principal's office or Miss Rivers. They probably think I made a hash of it.
Irene, you're just tired and tense. I told you at dinner.
You've been very kind.
I'm not trying to be kind. Honest, you have to believe me.
Pardon me. I hope I'm not intruding again.
Oh, not at all, Miss Moran.
I simply felt that, despite my personal feelings, I should congratulate you, Miss Burgess.
I feel touched.
I'm a very honest woman. I couldn't do anything else, seeing as I feel you put on a better production than your predecessor ever gave us.
Thank you so much.
Tut, tut. It's only my opinion, after all. Good evening, Norman. You won't have to give me rides home this year. I know you have other things on your mind. However, Miss Burgess, I'm not sure if my opinion will coincide with Miss Rivers' opinion. Good night.
Good night. You know, Norman, I think Miss Moran would like to be a nice woman. Somehow she's forgotten.
It's one of the dangers of our profession. Occupational hazard. Now do you believe me? The show was a success.
I still can't quite believe it yet.
Maybe I can convince you.
Nancy, what I say? I've been sitting outside that dressing room door for hours. Literally hours. Waiting for you. Now you won't even let me say it.
I wish to heavens you'd say it, young man. Whatever it is. And get it over with.
No, Daddy! No, Milk! I don't want to hear it!
Holy jumping catfish! All I wanted to say was that I thought you gave a great performance, Nancy.
Is that all?
No! I didn't! I was awful! And I deserve to be worse!
Daughter, you're hysterical. Can you explain to me why Nancy is hysterical?
I believe I can, Mr. Leverage. But I'd rather have Nancy tell you herself.
Well, Nancy, it's all over now. Please explain yourself.
Miss Burgess, you know, don't you? Yes, Nancy, I've been waiting for you.
New what? Why does everyone know that I don't?
And Andy knew it too, and you didn't tell. Why, Andy?
It wasn't my place to say, Nancy.
Don't get so excited, Mr. Leverage. The truth is, I don't know either. You? You? It's not important that you know.
I believe Milt's right. There's no need to get so excited, Mr. Leverage.
Excited? Who's excited? I'm not excited. Young lady, don't start treating me like one of your students here. I graduated high school a good many years ago.
There's no need to raise your voice to Miss Birch, Mr. Leverage.
And who are you?
I teach journalism here. My name's Carter.
Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Carter. Nancy and I have stood about as much as we need to stand from this entire school. And I have half a notion to snatch her out right now after what happens to her in regards to this play and put her in a private school where her talents will be recognized. And if that happens, Mr. Carter, I will assure you I will take great pleasure in explaining to Miss Burgess' superiors that she and she alone is to blame for my actions.
No, Daddy, you can't do that!
What?
It's not Miss Burgess's fault at all! It's mine!
Yours partially, but also your father's.
Nancy, I can't see the... What you say, young fellow?
Why do you think I didn't tell?
Here we go again! Tell? Tell what? To whom? About what?
Go ahead, Andy! Tell on me! Tell Miss Burgess! And the principal! And Miss Rivers! I'm a thief!
A thief? Nancy, what are you saying?
It's true, Daddy. Andy knew it, and I guess Miss Burgess knew too. I stole the playbooks the very first day of rehearsal so that the play would be postponed and I could play Lori's role. I'm sorry, Lori. I took your playbooks that day too. That's how much I wanted to play that role.
I don't believe it, Nancy. You wouldn't.
I did. And it's been torturing me ever since. And I'm glad I told.
I don't even know what to say.
Well, I know what you ought to say. You ought to take some of the blame.
blame on yourself, Mr. Leverage.
On myself?
Look, Mr. Leverage, how many nights this past week have I been at your house?
Too many.
Every night, while Nancy's been helping me with my trig, I forgot to mention, I passed my trig.
Great job, Milton.
And my father said, son, if you got hold of a girl who can pass any sense into that head of yours, you hang on to her. First and only sensible thing my father ever said.
Young man, you're off the subject. You've been at my house, studying for your lessons, popping popcorn, making fudge, giggling over gossip, and what?
You're not going to like this, Mr. Leverage.
And that's probably the first sensible thing you've ever said. Well, Nancy, if you're through confessing your sins in public, we'll be going.
I haven't finished yet, Mr. Leverage. Okay, I know this isn't the time or the place to say it, but you impress me as a very successful fellow.
Young man, you come down to my bank someday, and you'll be even more impressed.
It's not polite to interrupt like that, Mr. Leverage. Well, then I've started, I might as well go on. You know, the trouble with Nancy is, she can't do enough for you. The more you push, the harder she tries. Until she just doesn't know how to have fun anymore. Just because you're a big shot, you think she's got to be a big shot. Can't you let your daughter have a normal life like normal people? Sorry, but that's the way I see it.
Is any of this true, Nancy?
I'm afraid so, Daddy. I think so.
Say, how do you get that stuff off your face?
Cold cream, sir.
You need any help?
You mean you,
yes, sir. No one's talked to me that way since my wife died. I guess a man needs that every once in a while.
Oh, trust me, I got a lot more for you if you want to
do it. Nancy and I are both profoundly sorry for the trouble we caused you.
Miss Burgess, do you want to know something funny? I actually enjoy playing the mother role.
It certainly showed in your performance, Nancy.
I am sorry. Well, I believe that everyone here can forget those matters. Am I right?
I've already forgotten it.
I haven't heard a word.
Count on me.
Nancy, Sophie Cass is coming to my house for a party tonight. I'd like it if you join us.
Really, Lori? After all I've done?
We've just agreed to forget that.
Is Jocko taking you, Lori?
Jocko and I do have a date. Yes?
You think she'd go out with me? A date we made months ago. No, sirree. Perish the thought.
Andy, don't act like that!
Our stage room's out here, everybody. And flowers for Nancy.
Flowers? Who could have gotten me flowers?
Thank heavens it's all over. Now I can forget my lines.
Now? Now? What did she forget during the second act?
I don't care what she forgets. She learned to stop giggling.
That's true. Come on, guys. Let's just go to the party at Lori's already.
Better go make sure that all the props are turned first. Every seat in the house sold. That's what publicity will do. Isn't it, Mr. Carter?
Thanks. You did a great job.
No problem. Wait up, Sylvia!
It's amazing the human problems that your little production seems to be clearing up.
I still haven't heard a word from the principal's office or Miss Rivers. When he congratulated me, I wasn't sure if he was just trying to be polite or if he actually did enjoy himself.
You worry too much, Irene. From now on, I'd like to share your...
Darn fool walking out with one shoe. It really gets me.
Of all the times there's someone to lose a shoe...
Really gets me. What's that you said, Mr. Carter?
I said, you picked the darnest times to come barging in here.
Who? Me? All I gotta say is, you got a pluck of stage names waiting out there for yourself. Ain't you interested?
Not as interested as other things at the moment, but that can wait.
It can't wait forever. It's waited long enough already.
What in tarnation do I do now?
What do you want me to do? Crawl? I said I'm sorry. I said it 1,000 times. I'm sorry I suspected you of trying to get me out of the show.
It stopped mattering to me, Lori, a long time ago, whether you're in the play or not.
I'm warning you, Andy Fulbright. You'd better stop acting this way.
Acting? I'm not acting. I don't care. C-A-R-E. Give a darn.
Well, Mr. Fulbright, it might interest you to know that almost every boy in school was in love with me tonight. The football team sent me orchids. En masse.
I hope you like them. I hope they smell good.
They didn't smell at all. They were orchids. Aren't you even jealous anymore?
Me? Jealous?
I warned you, Andy Fulbright!
All that proves is you're crazy about me.
Now listen, you kids. The play's over. I'm in charge of the auditorium. If you want to fight, get you some boxing gloves. Come on, shoot!
Crazy about you? You?
Yes, me. Me.
Jonah. So you're the one who stole my shoe!
What? What?
I'll go. What good one shoe do you, or your wife? I'm sure I don't know. Perhaps you're a kleptomaniac. Are you a kleptomaniac, my good man?
Lady, I don't know what that is.
Then I'm sure you are. I could give you the name of a very good psychiatrist. I've used him for years. Although, he's in New York, and frightfully expensive. Still, if you are that sick, sir.
Sick? I can't afford to get sick. All I'm doing is waiting for Social Security this time, so I can get away from this nut house.
Nut house? Of course you refer to the theater. Many people refer to us that way. Morons!
I refer to you. It ain't logical. Your feet hurt, you kick off your shoe in the aisle, they trip someone, I find it, and all of a sudden, I'm crazy. Lady, for my money, the theater stinks. Oh, I'm suffering.
Blood, dead wood, atrophied brain cells, dead to wonder and delight. But here we have a young woman, half child, half pure womanly spirit. In short, a born actress. Helen Hayes, Katherine Hepburn, Judy Garland, make way for youth.
I'm cows that like this ever since Curtin came down, Lori. She thought you're terrific.
Terrific? I would not stoop to such a paltry word. Magnificent. Lori was magnificent.
I agree with you, Miss Roberts. Though I don't have your expertise in the theatrical world, I think Lori's been wasting her time writing news and editorials.
Angie! Writing editorials? Anyone can do that, anyone. But to waste such a talent as this behind a desk or in a college classroom, it's just sheer, unforgivable waste.
I couldn't agree with you more.
What are you up to?
Listen.
What are you trying to do?
Listen, Lori, I'm only giving my opinion. When I saw you on stage, with all the lights on you, and everyone watching and applauding, I knew I was wrong. The thing for you to do is chuck everything away. Scholarships, education, old worn-out boyfriends, and run off to Broadway with Jocko here.
What makes me think you're up to something? Andy, you stop that talk this instant. What's going on here? Here's a woman who will agree with me. Here's a lady who knows talent when she sees it. Miss Burgess, your leading woman should be on Broadway.
I don't think that's for us to decide.
But darling, it is so apparent. Even a person like you.
Well, I do think that Lori did a very fine job. Yes, but hard as it may be on your ego, Lori, I don't think that you should give up everything you've been working towards to take a chance like that. I'm so confused. I don't know what to... Of course I'd like to be able
really can't make a decision like that!
But Lori, you told me that you were close to making a decision anyways.
She decided weeks ago when she got theater in her blood.
I don't understand you at all! Don't you want me to go to the university with you?
University? Education? Did Catherine Cornell have a college degree? Did Hepburn? As a matter of strict fact, do I?
Miss Roberts, what show are you appearing in now?
Now? As of this moment, you mean?
This year.
As a matter of fact, it's been a very slow season. No scripts worth my time.
So, in other words, I believe the phrase is, you're at liberty?
Ms. Burgess, I am between shows.
You mean you're out of a job, don't you?
And what about last season, Miss Roberts?
Last season was even slower than this one.
According to my books on the Broadway theater, Miss Roberts.
It says you haven't appeared in a show in 4 years. Is that right? Well, I've been devoting my time to television.
How many weeks a year?
Are you attacking me, Miss Burgess?
How many weeks a year?
If you must know, sometimes as many as 10.
So, meanwhile, you sit and read scripts, hoping for a role, and wait, and wait, and wait. Am I right?
All that is a part of the glorious theater gamble.
And how many young actors and actresses, like Lori and Jocko here, descend on New York, hoping for a break? How many thousands?
I'm afraid, Lori, that getting a role on Broadway will be 1,000 times more difficult than getting the lead role here tonight.
How dare you attack me in this manner? I have been insulted by experts! I certainly do not need to sit here and listen to such statistical nonsense from amateurs like you!
Kyle, wait a minute.
And as for you, Jocko, not only are you as bad an actor as it was my very bad fortune to meet, but your father is paying for my train ticket back to New York. Good night! Of all the nerve in the world, I had to meet these
Miss Burgess! That was a very adequate and intelligent performance you just gave. I just want you to know that no matter how we may disagree on details, you and I are in fundamental agreement on principles. And I can speak for the entire faculty when I say congratulations on all that you have done.
Thank you so much.
Well, Lori?
Miss Burgess? I've been a fool!
You can say that again.
You lay off, Fulbright. I still owe you a black eye.
Oh, Jumbo! You deserved it! So did I! Andy ought to knock both our heads together!
What?
Imagine me thinking I'm some great actress when I was stage struck all along! Coming, Andy?
I'm right alongside you from now on.
Miss Burgess, I can't thank you enough!
Neither can I. So long, folks.
Good night!
I can't believe it! Imagine,
my father will faint. He'll just curl up his toes and sink straight through the floor. Mr. Leverage has just offered me a job and his bank. Thank you very much.
Hey, Nancy, how about you're going to the party with me?
Milt?
Yes, Nancy.
What is it your father says about you and me?
My father said, son, if you got hold of a girl who can pound any sense into the head of yours, you hang on to her.
Well, that's what my father thinks, too. Only vice versa, isn't it, Daddy?
Precisely. Only vice versa.
And I always do what my father says.
Bye. Nice ascot.
Bye, Daddy.
Good night, folks.
Good night.
Miss Burgess?
Yes, Jocko?
Have I been a heel?
Not exactly, Jocko.
Only then, that's worse.
Well, if you can see it, then I guess.
I'm not. I'm glad. Laura was right. I deserved it. I feel about 10 years older already.
The production of a play will do that to you, Jocko.
I'm going to go take a long walk, all by myself, and straighten things out. Good night, Miss Burgess.
Good night, Jocko. You had a very fine performance.
I know better than that now. Good night.
Good night.
They're turning out the lights, Irene. We're finally almost alone. At last.
At last, Norman. Let me out!
Kids, I'm sure they've all gone by now.
I'm sure too, Norman.
I got a hunch. That's against the rules.
It's okay, Tony. We're going to get married.
Don't tell me your troubles. I just pull the curtain. Pull the
curtain. Did you say married, Norman?
This is no time for discussion. I should have done this 4 weeks ago.
At last,